What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's tutorial I'm going to be talking about the top 10 shortcuts in Revit. So these are not the top 10 tools in Revit, these are the top 10 shortcuts. The top 10 shortcuts that are going to save you so much time when working on your project. So keyboard shortcuts just allow you to click on two buttons or two keys on your keyboard and you get to the tool or the menu or something like that which you're trying to access. Now I find these really useful and I decided to kind of make a short list of the top 10 which I think will save you a lot of time just because they get to some hidden menus or things like that. They would take a lot more time to get to manually instead of using a shortcut. So that's what this video is going to be all about. So it's going to be a list of those top 10, and then at the end of the video I'm going to show you how to customize your shortcuts in Revit, and also I'm going to be including a PDF that's going to that you can print out and then you can just look at it, and it can help you to learn the shortcuts along the way. Okay, so that's what the tutorial is going to be all about, and for this tutorial I'm going to be using one of the project files from one of my courses. I do courses each week on Patreon, first link in the description there. It's just a bit of a different platform where I go in depth into numerous Revit topics. I've got over 40 hours of content there, so if you're interested, check it out. You can also find all of my project files and one-on-one tutoring if that's something you're interested in. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get straight into the tutorial. So I'm going to get started with the most fun shortcut, or the shortcut that creates the most amazing result, and that's the BX shortcut. That's the shortcut for section box for selected objects. So section boxes are available in all 3D views. So here I am in 3D view, and here I have the option to turn on the section box. But if I select an element, for example this garage door that we have or something like that, I can just type in BX. And as you can see, it immediately creates a section box around that element. Now you can select that section box and maybe adjust it a little bit. So for example, here we have adjusted it a little bit, maybe open it up a little bit. So there we go. So we have just a section box around the garage. So it just allows you to make quick section boxes around the elements that you want to kind of select and show in a section box. And then you can adjust it and readjust it and just make it the size that you want. And then always you can go ahead here and turn off the section box and you're back to your regular 3D view. The next option is the next shortcut is going to be the Create Similar, or CS. So for example, here I am in my floor plan, and let's say I'm working and I want to create another wall, and I want it to be the same wall that I have here for the exterior. And as you can see, it's quite a complex wall. So instead of going into the wall command and then trying to find in the properties that exact wall and trying to find it here, the quicker option is just to select this wall and then type in CS for create similar, and there we go. Now if I just create a wall, okay, I think it's out of the it's out of the view here, but there we go. So if I just create that wall, as you can see, it will just start off the same command, so the wall command, and it's going to keep the wall type. So it's just going to copy some of the properties of the selected element that you've selected. And of course it works with all others. So for example, you want to make a small window or a large window like this, just type in CS, and there we go, we have that same window. You want to copy this door, select the door, CS, and then copy that door. So there you go, that's how you can just copy elements around. Okay, the next option is really cool, especially when you want to do a selection of multiple items. So for example, let's say I want to select some of these walls, or maybe these columns, they're quite kind of tricky to select. So let's say I go through three or four of these and then I accidentally click to the side and I lost that selection. Now it was a complex selection and it took a bit of time, so it's annoying that I lost that selection, but of course you have the option to reselect that last selection by just holding the control key and then tapping your left arrow button. So if I just tap that left arrow button while holding the control key, you're going to get that selection, that previous selection, and as you can see, all of these columns
highlight. So that's really cool. Whenever you lose selection or you maybe toggle through different views and you lose selection, you just use that control left arrow and you get that previous selection. As you can see here, it says structural columns, four of those. Okay, the next, the fourth one, is really useful whenever you're working in a project like this and you want to get ready for printing. So whenever you want to get ready for printing, you want to see what your lines look or what will they look when printed out. But when you're working on a project, sometimes they can be too wide or too thick, so it can be a bit annoying. So we have the thin lines option. So you just type in TL and that toggles the thin lines dialog. So you can type it in and it just turns it on and off. I find it really useful, especially when I'm preparing stuff for printing, because I can really quickly toggle between a graphic representation that I can work with. So here I can see, are these layers wrapping up properly? And then I turn on TL just to see what that would look like when printed out. So that's really useful to have a quick shortcut to make it really fast. Also, whenever setting up the graphics for your projects, it's really useful to use the visibility graphics overrides dialog. That dialog is here in the view properties, but sometimes when you're working on a project, you have something selected or you're just working around, it's really annoying to have to find that menu and then go to edit. So I really like the VG shortcut or the VV shortcut. I think both of those work, and both of those get you the visibility graphics overrides dialog. So it's a really quick way to get to that dialog. Also, while we're here talking about view settings, we also have the view range, which is even more difficult to get to because you have to scroll all the way down here, then find it. Where is that? Yeah, as you can see, it's really annoying. Okay, so here we go, view range. So it's really difficult to find, it takes a lot of time. And when you want to set the view range, you want to get to that dialog quickly. So I just type in VR and there we go, we have the view range dialog. So that VR shortcut will save you a lot of time and a lot of headache. Also, when playing around and maybe zooming in, seeing what everything looks like, sometimes you want to just go back and kind of zoom out just to see pretty much what the whole thing looks like. And for that, we have the zoom all function. So just ZA and there we go. So it kind of zooms out and you can see the whole view. And it's also really useful, especially when you have maybe some element that's kind of out of view and you can't find it. Or maybe if you lost, you kind of zoom out too far. You just type in ZA and it kind of just fits it to the screen. So that's really useful. So ZA, zoom all, kind of centers your whole model on your screen. Okay, the next one is dimensioning. So whenever you're working or if you're just doing regular aligned dimensions like these, or if you're just placing dimensions just to check something. So for example here, I'm going to use the TL to kind of toggle the thin lines dialog or the thin lines tool. And then let's say I want to measure here the width of this room. I can just quickly type in DI for dimension and then just do a simple dimension here from one side to the other. Oops, I don't want this one. There we go. And there we go. Now I have the width of that room. So for dimensioning, even though it's still here on the quick access toolbar, I just find it a lot easier to use the shortcut. It's quick and easy, and you just get to that command a lot quicker, and it doesn't interrupt your workflow. Okay, the next one is for placing families. So let's say I want to place another chair. I'm just going to type in CS for create similar. And let's say I want to place it, I don't know, I want to place it in one of these rooms. And as you can see, it would look weird to kind of have it face the wall. And it's really annoying to have to rotate. So it's really cool to have that kind of shortcut to use the space key to rotate families around. So that's also what I use pretty much all the time. Just when placing components like this, it's really useful to have that option to kind of rotate it around. Same thing goes with doors. So if I want to place a door here, I can just tap the space key to kind of flip it to the other side. And that will, of course, always save you a lot of time. Just because if you place a family and then you have to go to rotate and then you have to rotate it by the right value, as you can see, it takes a long time. And the next, the final one, the 10th shortcut, isn't just one shortcut. I wanted to show you what I like to do. when working on my projects, and that's I like to use all of these modify tools, and I like to use those shortcuts. So whenever you're kind of sketching out a new design or something like that, so maybe let's go, I don't know, to foundation level or wherever, and just try playing around with walls or something like that. So whenever you're playing around with the new layout or a new design like this, it's really useful to have these modify tools here. So on the modify tab, here we have these modify tools, but it can be kind of annoying if you want to do kind of quickly play around with this. It can be annoying to have to go to all of these tools. So what I like to do is I like to use shortcuts for all of them. So for example, I like to use AL for align, for example, when you have to align something like this. And when I want to rotate something, I just type in RO for rotate, and then I can, well, I can rotate that. I like to use the MV for move. So for example, if I want to move this whole segment, just type in MV and then move it wherever. Then I like to use copy. So for copying things, just CO for copy. There we go. I like to use also trim and extend. That's one of my favorite ones here on the modify panel. So just TR gives you trim and extend to corner, and then you can fix corners like this up, and also mirror both with pick axis and mirror with draw axis. So those are these two. MM gives you the pick axis. So something like this, and then DM gives you the draw axis, so then you can draw the axis, and there you go, you get that mirror. And also I like to use the array function as well, so just type in AR, and then you select the element, you hit enter. Here we can add a number, maybe, I don't know, 5, and let's go move to last. And there we go, we have a cool array. Maybe we can up this to 8. So all of these modify tools, I find it really useful to memorize all of the shortcuts, at least for these here, these 8. And then whenever working on a new layout where you have to kind of make changes quickly, just to kind of follow along with the speed or pace of your thinking, it's really useful to memorize all of these shortcuts over here. Okay, so those are my top 10. Well, a bit more, but I guess that part 10 was a whole series of these tools. But now I would just like to show you a couple of tips. If you type in KS, that will give you the keyboard shortcuts dialog. You can also find it here on View, and then under User Interface, here we have keyboard shortcuts. And then here you can search for a particular command, and then you can change a shortcut. And also here you will see all of the existing shortcuts for commands. And you can always scroll through and maybe find something that you would like to modify, and then you can change it. So here we have the command, then we have the shortcut, if it has a shortcut, and then here we have the path. So for example, the door, the command is the door, shortcut is DR, and then it's here on the architecture tab under the build panel. So that's basically how this works. Now here you can import a new shortcut schedule or something like that, where you want to maybe if you have an existing one. For example, if you use on your computer a certain new set of shortcuts, you can export that and then import that on your work computer or something like that. So you have that option as well. And if you want to change any of these, just click here. Click to Rofacia, and then you add your new shortcut, maybe RRF, or there we go, or something like that, and then you can use that shortcut. Now, I prefer to leave it as is and just use the regular Revit shortcuts. Also, there is a whole PDF that I'm going to include in the description of this video, where you can find all of the Revit shortcuts. So just one whole list, and then you can print it out and use it for your projects. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this quick tutorial. I hope you have learned something new. And please tell me in the comment section below what are your favorite Revit shortcuts, or what are the shortcuts that you use all the time, and do you use shortcuts, and do you consider them useful? Okay, so that's it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and share this video. And if you want these project files, my advanced courses, or one-on-one tutoring, check out my Patreon, first link in description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in a couple of days. Have a nice day.